Sir, am I audible clearly?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Very good afternoon, students. In this session, I am going to continue the objective questions of locomotion and movement. In last class, we have discussed up to 21st question. Now I am going to start from 22. Let us start question number 22. The each organ-vital muscle in our body is made up of a number of muscle bundles or fascicles held together by a common collagenous connective tissue layer. What it is called? A group of muscle fiber together called a muscle bundle or a fascicle. There are many fascicles in a muscle. These all fascicles are held together. They attached each other with help of a fibrous connective tissue layer is called as fascia. All muscle fascicles, muscle bundles or fascicles are held together with help of a fibrous connective tissue layer is called as fascia. Therefore, answer is second option. Next question. Sarcoplasmic reticulum is rich ions. The sarcoplasmic reticulum is the storehouse of calcium ions. It stores the calcium ions. Therefore, answer is 1. Next question. The functional unit of contractile system in the strepsomycin is sarcomere. A functional unit of contractile system is sarcomere. What is sarcomere? The portion of myofibril between two successive Z lines is called as sarcomere. So the sarcomere is functional unit of contractile system. Therefore, answer is 4. Next, the contraction of muscle is caused by. Contraction of a muscle is caused by myosin, actin, ATP, actomyosin. Here two important proteins are involved in the contraction of muscle fiber, myosin and actin. The together called as actomyosin. Therefore, answer is 4. Question number 26. The light band of the skeletal muscle are known as the light bands are called as isotropic bands and the dark bands are called as anisotropic bands. Isotropic band or I band. Light band or isotropic band or I band. One more is anisotropic dark band or A band. Here they are asking the light bands of the skeletal muscles are known as isotropic bands. Your third option, intercalated disc. What is intercalated disc? These are the specialized structures present in the cardiac muscles. Intercalated the specialized structure present in the cardiac muscles, which boost the transmission of electric impulse. Transmission of electric impulse from one cardiac to the another cardiac cell. Fourth option, cross bridges. Where the myosin head is bound to actin filament that result in the formation of cross bridge. for the question, answer is 1. Light bands are as isotopic band. Let us move on to the next question. The special contractile protein actin is found. The special contractile protein actin is found in thick filament. Option A. Option 1. Thick filaments of A band, thin filaments of I band, both thick and thin bands, whole of myofibril. Here actin is the major constituent of thin filament. Thin filament. There are two types, thin and thick filament. Thin filaments are also called as actinomers, and the thick filament also called as myosin filament. So actin is a major protein in thin filaments of I band. Of I band. At the same time, this actin is also present in I band. Slightly overlapped on myosin filaments. So actin filament we can find both in thick and thin bands. When we say the filament, it is present only in actin filament. When we say the band, I band and A band, the actin filament is present in both I band, A band, thin band. Therefore, answer is not option. Answer is not option. The protein is the part of both thick and thin bands. Here, thick band means A band, thin means I band. Let us take next question. Which of the following statements about the striated is or false? First option, which are the striated muscles? The skeletal muscles are called as striated muscles. In among these options, we have to find out the false statement. First, the thick filament in the A band are also held together in the middle of Okay, sorry for the interruption. There was network problem. Next. Question number 28. Which of the following statements about the striated muscle is or false? First statement, the thick filament in the A band are also held together in the middle of the band by a thin fibrous membrane called M-line. As in the diagram you can see, this is M-line. This area is the M-line. These yellow color structures are the thick filaments, and these are the thin filaments, and this is Z-line. Here in the first statement, they are saying that the thick filaments in the A band are also held together in the middle of this band by a thin fibrous membrane called M-line. As this is M-line, the thick filaments, the yellow color structures are the thick filaments, they are attached to the M-line. Therefore, first statement is correct. Next statement, in the center of each eye band is an elastic fiber called Z-line which bisects it. As the elastic membrane is called as Z-line. Here one thing you must remember that M-line is a fibrous membrane, Z-line is the elastic membrane. M-line is a fibrous membrane, Z-line is elastic membrane. So second statement also correct. Next, the thin filaments are firmly attached to the Z-line. Yes, these are the thin filaments. These thin filaments are attached to the Z-line. Third statement also correct. Next, this center part of thick filament, not overlapped by the thin filaments, is called the H-zone. In this portion you can see, this is wherever the yellow color is visible, that is A band. At the center portion of A band, where the thin filaments are not overlapped, that area is called as H zone or Hansen's zone. As fourth statement also correct, but in the question they are asking which is the false statement about striated muscles. There is no false statement. The all statements are correct. Therefore, answer is fourth option. None of these. Next question number 29. Which of the following statements about the molecular arrangement of actin in the myofibril is correct? Here they are asking incorrect statement about actin filament. Molecular arrangement of the actin filament. Each actin filament is made up of two F actins. They are helically wound each other. As here in the diagram you can see, these two green color structures are the two F actins. Green color structures are two F actin molecules. Each thin filament, this is complete a thin filament. Each thin filament is made up of two F actin. They are helically on each other. They wrapped around each other. Yes, first statement is correct. Next, each F actin. That means this one chain, one green chain. Each F actin is a polymer of monomeric G actins. Yes, each F actin is formed by many monomeric G actins. Many monomeric G-actin. Here one cycle, the one globular structure represent one G-actin. So many G-actin molecules are combined to form one F-actin. Here one thing you must remember, the polymerization of F-actin is carried out in the presence of F-actin by the G-actin molecules is occurred in the presence of magnesium ions. Next, statement 2 also correct. Each F actin is the polymer of monomeric G actin. So this one chain is one F actin. So one F actin is made up of many G actin. One globular structure represent one G actin. Next 3, two filaments of another protein, tropomyosin, also run close to the F actin throughout its length. Yes, these thread-like structures. The rope-like structures are the tropomyosin. There are two molecules of tropomyosin. They run along with each F-actin. There are two F-actin molecules, and along with that, two tropomyosin molecules are present. They run close to the F-actin molecules. These thread-like structures are tropomyosin. Next, a complex protein troponin is distributed at regular intervals on the tropomyosin. Yes, here you can see here three globular, small globular structures are the troponin. Protein is a complex protein because it is made up of three subunits: troponin C, troponin I, troponin T. So each troponin complex consists three subunits: troponin I, troponin T, troponin C. Troponin T is bind with the F-actin. Troponin I inhibit the binding of actin with myosin. Troponin C is the site for the binding of calcium ions. As your fourth statement also correct, but they are asking incorrect statement. There is no incorrect in this, among these all statements. So therefore answer is fourth option, none of these. Let us move on to the next question. Question number 30. ATP provides energy for muscle contraction by allowing for. ATP provides energy for attachment with elements. Option 1, an action potential formation in the muscle cell. No, the ATP is not involved in the formation of action potential. Next, cross-bridge detachment of myosin from the actin. No, cross-bridge attachment of myosin to actin. Yes, the third statement is correct. Cross-bridge attachment of myosin to actin. When myosin aids are attached to the actin filaments with the help of energy that is produced by the hydrolyzation of ATP. Therefore, answer is third option for this question. Answer is third option. A motor unit. And muscle motor neuron, all the muscle fibers that is innervates. Yes, this statement is correct about motor unit. Motor unit constitute a single motor neuron, and the all muscle fibers innervated nerve endings of a motor neuron. In this diagram you can see here, this is a motor neuron. These are nerve endings are telodendria, and this is a muscle, consists the group of muscle fibers. So here one a single motor neuron, but there nerve endings of a motor neuron innervated many muscle fiber. So these are all muscle fibers, a motor neuron together called as motor unit. Therefore answer for motor unit, a single motor neuron and all muscle fiber that is innervates. Third option. Next, let us move on to the next question. During muscle contraction, chemical energy is changed into electrical energy. Chemical energy is changed into mechanical energy. Chemical energy is changed into physical energy. Mechanical energy is changed into chemical energy. Here, during muscle contraction, ATP is utilized. ATP is nothing but chemical energy. So the chemical energy is changed into mechanical energy. Option 2. For 32, question number 32, answer is option 2. Next, smooth muscle fibers are cylindrical. No, they are not cylindrical. The skeletal muscle fibers are cylindrical. Unbranched. Yes, they are unbranched. Striated. No, the smooth muscles are not striated. Multinucleated. No, the smooth muscles are not multinucleated. The skeletal muscles are multinucleated. And voluntary. No, the smooth muscles are not voluntary. They are invalid. Next option, second one. Spindle shaped. Yes, smooth muscles are spindle shaped, unbranched, non-striated, uninucleate, and involuntary. And yes, these all characters are belongs to smooth muscle fibers. They are spindle shaped, unbranched, non-striated, and next question. Electron microscopic studies of the sarcomere have revealed that during muscle contraction, what happens during muscle contraction? The width of A band remains constant. Yes, the width of A band does not change. Next, the width of H zone increases. The width of H zone increases. No, this statement is wrong because the width of H zone will decrease. Width of H zone decreases. Next, the width of I band increases. No, this statement also wrong because width of I band decreases. Next, the diameter of the fiber increases. The diameter of the fiber increases. This statement also wrong because diameter of fiber decreases. So among the four, only the first statement is correct. The width of A band remains constant. There is no change in the A band. Remaining options are incorrect. Therefore, answer is 1. Let us move on to the next question. Put the following statements in proper order to describe the process of muscle contraction. Here some steps regarding muscle contraction they are given. We have to arrange in the order. The first signal sent by the central nervous system via motor neuron. Yes, the first step is the signal should come from the central nervous system via motor neuron. When the signals are reached to the nerve ending of the motor neuron, acetylcholine, the neurotransmitter acetylcholine, releases into the motor end plate. Yes, here D statement will come to this second place. The neurotransmitter acetylcholine end plate. A second one is D. Next, when the acetylcholine is released into the motor end plate, that causes the action potential, that generates the action potential in the sarcolemma. But this statement is not given in the options. When the action potential generate in the sarcolemma, that stimulate the terminal cisterna of sarcoplasmic reticulum to release the calcium ions. Yes, the third step will come, release of calcium ions from sarcoplasmic reticulum. When calcium ions releases, what happens? They are bind to the troponin C, then the active sites will open, then myosin heads will bind with the actin filaments. So form that result in the formation of cross bridge. But all steps are not given, only few steps are given. So A, signal sent by the central nervous system via motor neuron. This is the first step. Next, generation of neurotransmitter acetylcholine released motor end plate. This is the second step. A, D. Next, generation of action potential in the sarcolemma? B. A, D, B. Next, C. Release of calcium ions from the sarcoplasm. C. Next, E. Sarcomere shortens. So therefore, answer is second option. Next, question number 36. The repeated activation of the muscle can lead to the accumulation of lactic acid due to the anaerobic when the muscle skeletal muscle undergo repeated contraction because of lack of the oxygen, they exhibit anaerobic respiration, in that lactic acid is released. So answer is for 36 question, answer is second option. Next, which of the following states? One, statement one, smooth muscles are found in the urinary bladder, alimentary canal and genital tract. As smooth muscles majorly the found in the visceral organs. So these all organs, so urinary bladder, alimentary canal and genital tract consists smooth muscles. Next statement, a striated muscle is a syncytium, multinucleate. As the skeletal muscles are multinucleate. Then one, what is the function of cells because that is essential condition? Statement to started some, so statement three is false. Therefore, seventh question answer is three. Four, we'll see the fourth statement. The plasma is called as sarcolemma, sarcoplasmic reticulum. Fourth statement also correct. Next, source of calcium and reticulum is the storehouse of calcium ions. Therefore, answer is fourth option. Your first option, T-tubule, is a part of triad system. The T-tubule is the invaginated part of, for 38th question, fourth option. Next question number 39. Match column 1 with column 2. Here some points are given regarding thin and thick filaments. We have to match. First one, structural and functional unit of the myofibril. Structural and functional unit of myofibril is the sarcomere. So A is third one. Protein of thin filament is actin. So B is fourth one. Next, protein of thick filament is myosin. C is second one. Next, the central part of thick filament not overlapped by thin filament is called H zone. Therefore, answer is a fourth option. For this question, answer is fourth option. In this diagram, you can see the central part where the actin filaments are not overlapped onto the myosin, not overlapped, that area is called as H zone. So next question number 40. The main function of tropomyosin in the skeletal muscle include. Main function of tropomyosin. It masks the sites on actin filament to avoid the binding with myosin filament. First option is given, the sliding on action to produce the shortening. No, this is the not function of tropomyosin. Next, second option, releasing calcium ions after initiation of contraction. No, the calcium ions are not released from the tropomyosin. Calcium ions are released from the sarcoplasmic reticula. Next, third option, acting as a reflexing protein on actin filament by the tropomyosin during resting state. Therefore, the third statement is correct statement for the tropomyosin function. So, for question number 40, answer is third option. Next, question number 41. The tropomyosin is moved by which of the following proteins? Tropomyosin is moved by which of the following protein? As I told that in the earlier class, the previous class, when the calcium ions are bind to the troponin C, the tropomyosin complexes move away. But here calcium ions are not given, but another name for the calcium ions is given, that is calmodulin. First option is nothing but calcium ions. Tropomyosin is moved by which of the following protein? It is a derivative of, it is chemically similar to the calcium ions. So, for 41 question, answer is first option. Next, 42. Which of the following statements is false? Each myosin is a polymerized protein. Yes, each myosin filament is made up of many miromyosin molecules. Each myosin filament is made up of many miromyosin molecules. Hence, it is polymerized protein of miromyosins. First statement is correct. Next, second statement. Many miromyosins constitute one thick filament. Many miromyosins constitute one thick filament as around 200 to 300 miromyosins together form one thick filament. As second statement also correct. Next, each miromyosin's tail is called heavy miromyosin and head is called light miromyosin. This statement is wrong because tail is called as light miromyosin and head is called as heavy miromyosin. So third statement is false statement. Next, we'll see the fourth statement. The globular head is an active ATPase enzyme and as binding sites for the ATP and active site for the actin. As this statement also right, the globular head of the myosin consists ATPase enzyme and also active site for the binding of myosin filament and a active site for the binding of ATP. Therefore, 42 question answer is third option, that is false statement. Next, let us move on to the next question. Question number 43. Cardiac muscles require a large amount of energy or ATP. Cardiac muscles require the large amount of energy or ATP for their incessant working throughout their life. That is why. Very numerous, large and elongated mitochondria. In the first lung, ATP should come and the last one, mitochondria. Cardiac muscles, they never get fatigue. Why the cardiac muscle, they never get fatigue? Because of the continuous blood supply and the presence of numerous elongated, large number of mitochondria and myoglobin molecules. The large amount of myoglobin molecules, which are oxygen storing molecules. Because of these characteristic features, the cardiac muscles never get fatigue. So, ATP and mitochondria. That is second option. Basically, in the muscles, that causes which causes the release of calcium science on this sarcoplasmic reticulum. This sarcoplasmic reticulum. So your electrical attainment directly causes release of calcium ions from this sarcoplasmic reticulum. Therefore, answer is third option. Next question number 45. Which of the following is not a feature of red muscle fiber? As you all of you know that there are two types of muscle fiber, red muscle fiber and white muscle fiber. Here some characteristic which is the not feature of red muscle fiber we have to find out. They have plenty of mitochondria. Yes, red muscle fiber consists of plenty of mitochondria and the numerous myoglobin molecules. And this on oxygen. I am a sarcoplasmic reticulum is given. This statement, the third statement is wrong because the red muscle fiber contains low content of sarcoplasmic reticulum, whereas white muscle fiber consists more amount of sarcoplasmic reticulum. Red muscle fiber, plenty of mitochondria. In white muscle fiber, less number of mitochondria. And red muscle fiber, numerous myoglobin molecules in sarcoplasmic amount of sarcoplasmic reticulum is more in white muscle fiber, less in red muscle fiber. But in the third option they are given, they have high amount of sarcoplasmic reticulum. This statement is wrong. So we have to select the statement. Let us move on to the next question. How does the troponin-tropomyosin complex affect the cross-bridge cycle? What is cross-bridge? When myosin heads are bind with the actin filament, that result in the formation of cross-bridge. Here we'll see the options. The first option, when the concentration of calcium is low, the troponin-tropomyosin complex blocks actin. Binding can the sarcoplasm. There will be no binding of calcium to the troponin C. So at that time, the troponin tropomyosin complex block the active sites on the actin filaments. But when the calcium ion concentration increases in the sarcoplasm, some of the calcium ions are bind with the troponin C. When calcium ions are bind with the troponin C, the tropomyosin complex is move away from the active sites. To actin and initiate the cross-bridge cycle. As this statement is 100% correct, because when calcium ion concentration increases in the sarcoplasm, calcium ions are bind with the troponin C. When calcium ions are bind with the troponin C, troponin tropomyosin complex is move away from the active sites on the actin filaments. Now the active sites are exposed to the myosin filaments. Then myosin heads are bind with the actin filaments that result in the formation of cross bridge. First statement is correct. Next, the troponin tropomyosin complex regenerates the ATP for the myosin ATPase. This statement is wrong. Troponin tropomyosin complex will not involves in regeneration of the ATP. Next, third statement, the troponin tropomyosin complex regulate the calcium release from the terminal cisternae. This statement also wrong, because the calcium ions are released from the terminal cisternae when the action potential spread to the triad system. Next, fourth option, the troponin tropomyosin complex bind to the myosin head, facilitating contact with the actin filament. This also wrong, because troponin tropomyosin complex will not bind to the myosin head.
next. Question number 46, answer is 1. 47. A collagenous connective tissue layer that hold the muscle bundles together is, already we have discussed that. Muscle bundles are called as fascicles. The fascicles are held together with the help of collagenous connective tissue is called fascia. Here perimycium. Perimycium, endomycium, epimycium. A muscle fiber is surrounded by fibrous connective tissue is called as endomycium. Is surrounded by complete a fascicle is surrounded by a fibrous connective tissue is called as perimycium. A complete muscle is surrounded by a fibrous connective tissue is called as epimycium. Next, let us go on to the one of the following is a wild disease that weakens the muscles. First, atrophy meaning degeneration. Osteomyelitis. And the question is asking to find out that degeneration is not caused by poliomyelitis. Yes, this caused by also degeneration of muscle, degeneration of muscle, especially next fourth option muscular hypertrophy is increasing the size of the muscles. Muscle cell is called as muscular hypertrophy. Of cells is called question they are asking to find out the viral disease, so therefore answer is second option. Let us move on to this question. The Cori cycle develop relationship between Cori cycle. It explain glucose metabolism. Repeated contraction of the muscle is result in the production of lactic acid. Repeated contraction of muscle is result in the production of lactic acid. But this lactic, when the lactic acid accumulate in the muscle, that leads to the fatigue. But what happened to the lactic acid here? In the diagram you can see, this is a muscle cell. Here first glucose is converted into pyruvic acid. This is if oxygen is present available, oxygen is abundant, the pyruvic acid is completely break down to produce 38 ATP molecules. If the oxygen is not available, in the absence of oxygen, the pyruvate is converted into lactate. And this lactate is moved to the liver cell. Lactate is moved to the liver through the blood. In the liver, the lactate is converted into pyruvate, then pyruvate is converted into glucose. This complete cycle is called as Cori cycle. Here option one, muscle glycogen into liver glycogen. As in the liver, this glycogen is converted into glucose is converted into glycogen. In the muscle also converted into glycogen. Muscle glycogen and the liver glycogen, muscle glycogen and the liver glucose, muscle glycogen and the blood glucose. As this whatever lactate is produced, that is reached to the liver through the blood, again in the liver, when it is converted into glucose, it enters into the blood. Therefore, answer is fourth option. Question number 50, the strongest muscle in the body is? The strongest muscle in the human body is the masseter that is located in the lower jaw. Masseter, strongest muscle is masseter. The stapedius is the smallest muscle present in the inner ear. Gluteus maximus is the largest muscle present in the buttock. Sartorius is the longest muscle present in the hip. Stop here. The remaining questions will continue in the next class.